Greetings, Earthlings. This is the artist formerly known as Grim Jim C, and I'm bringing you another inbox review. This time of this rather special new kit from Meng. Well, what's special about it? Well, it's the new Bradley M2A3 with BUSK, the Bradley Urban Survivability Kit, which is interesting in itself. But what's really amazing about it is this. Look how deep that box is, and look also at what this is showing. This is showing the insides of the vehicle, and there is a reason for that, which is this logo here. I'll try and zoom in. Yep, this kit has full interiors. Now, the nice thing about Meng kits is when they say they'd have full interiors, they ain't kidding. And this is very much not kidding. This kit has details for, as well as the hull and everything, has details for the crew compartment, the driving compartment, the turret, and it also has a full engine and transmission. And it doesn't do it in a half-hearted way either. It has some really, really good details. instructions. It's a nice sort of saddle stitch booklet with a quick history of the Bradley in looks like Chinese, English, Japanese and Russian. And there's even a little potted biography there of Omar Bradley himself. And then we launch into the build. So it has separate tyres for the wheels, poly caps to hold the wheels on, which is always nice. You can remove the wheels easily then for painting. It has separate torsion bars for the suspension. So the suspension actually is workable. You can actually it'll actually conform to terrain. These parts here are for the shock absorbers or friction snubbers, not sure what they are, but these are also workable. Once you've actually had the wheels, managed to get the wheels attached, then you go on to building the interior. So there's quite a few steps to the interior. Some detail of additional armour plate, even the seats, which often in these kits are rendered as one or two pieces. These have proper frames underneath. There is a radio kit. And then you get on to building the engine. So for the engine interior, there is 1, 2, 3, 4 steps just to build the engine. There don't appear to be that many parts to the engine, which actually is quite good, but it does seem to be very detailed. I'll show you some of the parts in a minute. They're very, very well detailed. So, as you can tell from here, the engine compartment is going to be fairly full. There's lots of nice call-outs for colour. This is the driver's compartment. There's call-outs for colour, and there's also call-outs for decals, because all of the warning decals and information placards in the interior are also supplied. So we get now on to building the turret, or at least the turret guard. More interior. I'm not going to go through every single step. Some nice touches here. These are the seat belts, and they're actually supplied as sort of vinyl, so they'll kind of hang and fold realistically. There's a few etched brass details to go on, and here we start actually tricking out the outside. Lots of nice parts there for the busk armour, the interior here of the turret with a nice coaxial machine gun here with a flexible belt. So basically it's all there. The only thing that doesn't appear to be here, I haven't seen properly anyway, is an actual breech for the main gun. So I'll have to look to see whether that's actually there, but I couldn't see it in my first look through. So more details, a nice very detailed tow launcher here for the side of the turret. Lots of up-to-date antennae and stuff again for the turret. The sprue map. There are, I think, how many sprues did I count? Let's have a look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 sprues, 3 etch frets, 2 parts for the hull, and presumably partridge in a pear tree. And 2 paint schemes here, I beg your pardon, 3 paint schemes, all for a sand yellow vehicle during the occupation of Iraq. Okay, that's it for the instructions. On now to the parts themselves. Now, this box, big though it is absolutely packed. Now, I've had these parts out of here once and I had a lot of trouble getting them back in. It really is packed full of parts. What is very nice about these, it's immediately obvious when you start to get some of these bits out. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to pick this up on the camera, so apologies in advance. You probably can't see that. The upper part of these armour sections has a non-slip surface on it. And this is something that we find all the way through this kit. Anything that should have a non-slip surface on it, it does. And I'm just blown away by this kit, I have to say. The interior parts are moulded in this slightly lurid green. I'd have been perfectly happy to have had the whole kit moulded in grey, to be honest, but interior parts are in green. Parts for the engine and transmission are in grey. More green parts here. There's the seat backs, some interior armour. Again, I'm not going to go into these in particular detail, except for anything that stands out. This is the cargo hatch and also the loading hatch for the tow missiles. Again, there's an applique armour plate on here, and all of this has a nice non-slip texture to it. Very, very nice indeed. Very, very good. I really am impressed with what Meng have done with this. They've really done a wonderful job. I'm going to just see, I'm in my own light, I know, just see if I can actually, if you can make that out on there. Might just about to be able to make it out. Lovely, lovely texture. These parts are for the air conditioners that fit on the back of the hull. Again, the superb piece of design. These have an etched grill that goes over each of these fans, and then there's a further etched grill that fits over the front of the whole unit. So they've really gone to town on this. More BUSK units, again non-slip on the top surfaces. This is the turret shell. More turret sections. Some parts for the main hull. This is the driver's hatch, again non-slip surface on it, and this is slide molded so that there's even detail on the edge here of the driver's hatch. if you can make that out. Yeah, just it's an outstanding attention to detail. The main door, again, the inside has non-slip surface on it. These things here look like bits of weed. These are actually the seat belts moulded in vinyl. There are some mudguard sections as well, moulded in vinyl. Parts here, these are anything that's kind of duplicated goes in these parts. these are the refills for the tow missiles, some antennae here for the turret. More armor sections. The wheels, very, very crisply molded, but with separate tyres, and torsion bars as well, to replicate the suspension of the real thing. Upper and lower hull has one part tubs, which is to be expected, I think, nowadays. These are the tracks. They are individual links, and they're designed, so the instructions say, I'm not going to be able to focus on that very well, I'm afraid, sorry about that, but they're designed to click together. Now, having seen what has happened with some of their other click together tracks, I'm not sure I trust Meng on these. I know the ones for the AUF-1 were ostensibly clicked together, but actually were more like fall apart. I'm hoping these will be better. Each of these, well, they come as two links attached together, so each link will have two points to clean up, but hopefully shouldn't be too bad. There's 188 of them, in case you're wondering. I'm sure you wouldn't be able to sleep well tonight without knowing that. Some clear parts. Now, this is again another typical Meng thing. The parts for the periscopes are moulded in clear plastic and also in a kind of a bluish greenish tinted plastic to replicate armour. And you get duplicate sprues. I'm not sure how useful that's going to be for this vehicle, but it's a very, very nice touch. Another clear sprue here for other parts of the optics and the running lights. Some pieces of metal tube for parts of the suspension, and three etch frets. This one is for the air conditioners. This is what I mentioned before. These grills go over the fans of the air conditioner, and then these outer grills go over the whole lot. Some very, very fine grills here for the engine. This one's been a little bit dinged, but that goes over the sights for the main gun. And more grills. Some brackets. I think that's a stay for the driver's door. And this, I think, again, even fuller marks to Meng for this. This is a painting stencil, so you can spray your wheels in your favourite tyre black colour, and then put that over them, and then just shoot them with your sand yellow. Again, the tracks, you can spray them in your favourite track colour, and then use this mask just to shoot the track pads with your favourite track rubber colour. I mean, for the sake of a bit of brass, that's going to make life a lot easier, save a lot of time. A set of warning placards in just a bit of printed paper. Okay, I suppose. A lot nicer than the ones that come in Trumpeter's LAV3 kit, I must say, because these ones actually look pretty good. The ones in the trumpeter kit are dreadful, they're all pixelated, obviously very low resolution scans. And finally, a set of decals, including lots of warning placards, lots of warnings that say pinch point, and something I've never seen before, even a little tiny keyboard for the computers. Okay, well, it'll take me a while to get that packed up again, so I'll just pop the box lid back on. That is the kit, Meng's new M2A3 Bradley with BUSK 3. this just arrived from Lucky Models just today. I must admit, when I saw the Lucky Models, I thought, I've got to have that, it looks fantastic. And it set me back about $70, which is about 40-something Earth pounds. So I thought, well, it's not really cheap, but I'll go for it anyway. But when I think about it, if you consider that something like a Tamiya's new Elephant kit is going for about £50 nowadays, there is masses more in this. The detail and the number of parts in this is just phenomenal. So I really recommend this for if you're a modern armor modeler, or a modeler of modern armor, I should say. I don't really care how modern you are, but this is going to be a kit that you're going to want to get. If you have to raffle family members to get it, do so. You won't regret it. They might, you won't. It really is a superb kit. That's the latest thing. I'm really quite excited about this kit, in case you couldn't tell. It really is a very, very well detailed, well thought out kit. And that's the thing I like about Meng. There seems to be more about them than just making a kit that kind of looks right. They have a real sense of how modelers want to actually build kits, which is why they give stencils, is why they provide a lot of extra details. So there we go, new from Meng model. I've got a feeling that we're going to see a lot of these around. If you have any comments, I'd love to hear them. And in the meantime, happy modelling, and goodbye for now.